Hi, everybody. My name is Chelsea, and I work for the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation. I'm here today at Norrie Point Environmental Center in Statsburg, New York, on the Hudson River Estuary. For those of you who have seen our previous videos, you may have heard the word estuary before. For those of you who have not, an estuary is where fresh water meets the ocean, or meets salt water. This happens all around the world, where freshwater rivers meet the ocean. And it happens here on the Hudson River. Freshwater from rain and snow melt and tiny little lakes up in the Adirondacks all flows down river until it meets the Atlantic Ocean. But the Atlantic Ocean also pushes salt water up the river with the high tides. I'm here today to show you what happens physically in the river when that salt water from the ocean meets the fresh water from the Hudson River. This is called the salt front demo. A salt front is the interface or the exact meeting point where that huge mass of salt water moves up and meets the fresh water. So right where they meet is called the salt front. And this happens about 70 miles up river from the Atlantic Ocean. Where I am today, I'm about 90 miles from the ocean. So the salt front is down river, about 20 miles down river. So if I were to measure the salinity of the water at Norrie Point here today, I would probably measure zero. So there probably wouldn't be any salt in the water today. But let's see what happens when that fresh water and that salt water meet. I have 2 cups of fresh water currently, and I'm going to add salt to one of them. So this represents the Atlantic Ocean. Now, if I were to mix these together, we wouldn't be able to tell which was the fresh and which was the salt. So I've also brought food coloring. I'm going to make the fresh water blue, and I'm going to make the salt water red, if I can. There we go. It might be more of a pink. All right. Now this mechanism that I have to show you the salt front is this plastic contraption that has a little plastic barrier in the center to keep those two waters separate. So this could represent the Troy Dam in Albany, New York, the Hudson River 150 miles south to the Atlantic Ocean. So let's see what happens. I'm going to pour the salt water into the ocean side. Doo-doo. And I'm going to pour the fresh water into the freshwater side. All right, now, remember, fresh water, salt water. Fresh water, salt water. Let's see what happens when they meet. Whoa. Now, the salt water, the red, is underneath the fresh, and they're mixing and they're flowing, but they're kind of staying separated. If you noticed, when I first removed that plastic barrier, the salt water immediately wedged down underneath the fresh. And the reason for this is because salt water is more dense, heavier, than fresh water. that remains on the top. Now, if we were to leave these all day and pretend this actually is the Hudson River, so it's flowing back and forth with high tide and low tide, so they're mixing and mingling, eventually it would all become salty. Maybe less salty than the salt, than the initial salinity of the salt water, but all of it would mix and mingle and become salty. Now in the Hudson River, the salt front, where that salt water actually goes, moves up the river until, is usually right around 70 miles, 70 river miles, which means it's 70 miles upriver from the Atlantic Ocean. And it usually doesn't move much further up from this. And the reason why is because the upper stretches of the Hudson, the river, have a constant input or flow of fresh water into the river. So whether rain, snow melting moves into the river, tiny little lakes in the Adirondacks and in the watershed surrounding the river, all of that fresh water is constantly pushing down to the ocean. But the ocean pushes back with high tides. So that salt front will never move further, further north as long as we have that fresh water input coming in. Now the reason that we study salinity here at the DEC and at Norrie Point is because the amount of salt in the water determines what organisms live there, what plants and animals can live there. So for example, if we were to go fishing today here at Norrie Point, we may fish up a species that looks like this, which is a bluegill sunfish. This fish cannot tolerate high levels of salinity or salt in its water, and it's adapted to live in fresh. So if that salt front in the Hudson River were to keep moving its way up, you may find species of bluegill or freshwater species like the bluegill also moving up to avoid that salty front. Vice versa, or on the other side of that, if we were to catch a fish down in New York Harbor, closer to the Atlantic Ocean, we may catch one like the birdfish that's adapted for millions of years to live in salt water. And so different organisms can live in different salinities and have adapted to do so. This birdfish and other animals that live in salt water have adapted to removing some of that salt from their body, whether it's through a specific organ, like a gland that secretes salt, whether it's a behavior where they're having to come to the surface for fresh water when it rains. Behaviorally, physically, these animals and these plants have adapted to live in different salinities. And so salinity of the water can tell us a lot about the plant and animal communities that live there. All right, well, thank you for watching the salt demo, and I hope that you check out some of our other videos as well. See you later.